हेलो। फ्रॉम कॉल्स एनीवन कैन यू डिफाइन व्हाट डू मीन्स बाय साइक्लोपीडिक रिफ्रैक्शन?
सर सेम एज अमन साइड साइक्लोप्लेजिक रिफ्रेक्शन एक टाइप का रिफ्रेक्शन होता है जिसमें हम लोग मतलब सिलेरी सिलेरी मसल्स को साइक्लोप्लेजिक ड्रग्स के थ्रू थोड़ा टेम्परेली हम उसको रिलैक्स कर देते हैं या फिर पैरालाइज कर देते हैं ताकि हमारा आई जो है वो अकोमोडेट करके ठीक पावर को मतलब एरर जो भी है पावर हमें ठीक से पता चल जाए, क्योंकि अगर वो अकोमोडेशन करेगा तो हम पावर ठीक से नहीं पता चल पाएगा।
One girl, 1 to 8. Anyone? Why we perform this test from girls? Anyone? What are the main aim to do the psychophysic practice? Pitika Sharma.
Yes, sir.
Can you explain me why you do the psychophysic reaction? What are the main aim to do the psychophysic reaction? Yes, Aman said that psychophysic reaction is
Sir,
done
why?
just to obtain the accurate refraction, means accurate power of
Sir,
that.
why? सर मतलब कभी कभी पेशेंट ओवर फोकस कर लेता है और मतलब उसकी अकोमोडेशन ज्यादा करने की वजह से हमारी जो एक्यूरेट पावर होती है वो नहीं मिल पाती है, इसलिए हम उसको उसकी स्लरी बॉडीज को थोड़ा रिलैक्स करते हैं मतलब टेम्पोरेली।
सर एरर रिड्यूस करने के लिए करते हैं मतलब साइक्लोपेजिक रिफ्रेक्शन तो मेनली।
हाँ भाई।
Anyone more? Lucky? Mr. Lucky, आप बताइए। Lucky आया है? Hello? Mr. Lucky Ali? I think he is getting some problem. Anyone? Muskan? You want to add something? Hello, Muskan.
सर मेनली साइक्लोप्लेजिक ड्रग्स को यूज किया जाता है, मतलब कि एकोमोडेशन को रिलैक्स करने के लिए किया जाता है। जब कोई पेशेंट मतलब कि फोकस नहीं कर पाता है टारगेट पे तो उसे साइक्लोप्लेजिक डाल कर दिया जाता है। और सर साइक्लोप्लेजिक ड्रग डालने का कुछ सारे मेडिसिन का कुछ इफेक्ट रहता है कि कुछ मतलब कि लिमिट टाइम में आता है उसका सर?
Lucky, we are not audible to your voice. Okay, let's come in. So, cyclopropic refraction was first put in the scientific basis.
Sir, 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 Lucky का आवाज नहीं आ रहा है। उसका नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम है, इस कारण से आवाज नहीं आ रहा। मैसेज किया वो।
Just listen. So, before going to the cyclopropic refraction, so cyclopropic refraction was first put in the scientific basis by the donor. And the universal accepted after the publications of the donor. Okay, so anomalies of the accommodation and refraction of the eye in 1864. So as I told, what do you mean by cycloplegic refraction? So many of you have responded the word. So cyclo means ciliary. Okay, ciliary muscles of eye, and plegia means to pulverize the muscle. So if you talk about the cycloplegic, then if you combine it, then there will be the ciliary pulverizing. So we can tell there will be the pulverization of our ciliary muscle. So what will be their use? So as I earlier talked about the anticholinergic agents, okay, and which blocks the response of our ciliary muscle and iris splenser muscle, which cause the accommodations of the lens and relax and mediasis. So a cyclophagic reduction is a procedure used to determine a person's complete refractive error or by temporarily pulverizing the ciliary body using the cyclophagic eye drop. So during this stage, the accommodation of the lens is fully relaxed so that we can obtain the accurate refractive error of our eye. And so it can be done in the child, in the adult. Okay, so it is not recommended that only child is having, we have to do the cyclophagic refraction. So cyclophagic refraction ye hai jaise hum log sirf bacche mein nahi karenge, adult mein bhi karte hain. Okay, तो क्यों करते हैं, जैसे चाइल्ड में क्यों इम्पोर्टेंट रहता है, क्योंकि चाइल्ड वगैरह सब क्या करता है, फोकस नहीं कर पाते हैं. हम लोग जो भी टारगेट वगैरह सब देते हैं, वो लोग फोकस नहीं कर
पाते. सर आपकी आवाज क्लियर नहीं आ रही सर,
सॉरी. सो जो भी हम लोग साइक्लोपेजिक रिफ्रैक्शन वगैरह सब करते हैं, वो हम लोग बच्चे में नहीं करेंगे, बच्चे में ही नहीं करेंगे, बच्चे में भी करेंगे, एडल्ट में भी करेंगे. ओके, तो मेनली हम लोग बच्चे में साइक्लोपेजिक रिफ्रैक्शन क्यों इम्पोर्टेंट है, क्योंकि बच्चे वगैरह सब हम लोग क्या करते हैं, टारगेट जो भी टारगेट दिया जाता है रिफ्रैक्शन करने के टाइम में, वो टारगेट पर फोकस नहीं कर पाता है. तो वो लोग क्या करते हैं, एकोमोडेट ज़्यादा करते हैं. इस वजह से साइक्लोपेजिक रिफ्रैक्शन मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट रहता है फेस फैशन फेस वॉकिंग जो
हेलो हेलो
हेलो तो So cyclopedic refraction remains a time tested, reliable and valid procedure for obtaining an accurate refraction. Okay. So without cyclopedic drugs, determining a true refractive status of some patient would be put off with the error. So cyclopedic refraction is essential for the proper diagnosis of refractive error in a patient with having refractive error or accommodative isotropia, pseudomyopia, latent hyperopia, anisometropia, anamyopia. So I am not going to discuss about this. What is isotropia? What is pseudomyopia? What is latent hyperopia, anisometropia, anamyopia? I think all of you are heard about this. So additional cyclopedic refraction is important to determine the refractive error in patients who are uncooperative and uncommunicable. Or any patient who are deaf, dumb, and unable to hard of hearing, or the child who is unable to speak, and any child that is uncooperative. So these are the cases that we have to perform the cyclophagic refraction. So today we are going to discuss about the indication, precautions, and contraindications associated with use of cyclophagic drugs in refraction. So in this slide we'll discuss about the clinical topics of selecting an appropriate cyclophagic agent, administrative technique and procedure of refraction, and also the general consideration for the spectacle discarding, and also the use of cyclophagic drugs is ocular and systemic side effect. So if we talk about the cyclophagia, then it is a condition when the accommodation is fully relaxed and the retinoscopic finding for the both distance and near remains same. So if we talk about the completeness of the cyclophagia, it is determined by the assessing the residual accommodation by push-up test. So here the mediasis and cyclophagia do not complete at the same time. So most often when there is complete mediasis and the cyclophagia is considered to be complete for the refraction. So the refraction may be unnecessary delay or additional drugs may be used unnecessary. So what are the indication and advantage of cyclophagic refraction? So cyclophagic refraction play a very important role in refractive evaluation of young patient, and thus should be performed during the first time in pediatric, suppose in pediatric age group, like in children, those who come for the comprehensive eye examination. So there will the numerous clinical situation for the cyclophagia, and that can be supplied the practitioner any of the optometry with the informative that could not be otherwise be obtained. So it is a why used to perform a cyclophagia examinations in hand with scholar and pre-scholar. Okay, because these styles often have the variable fixation with accommodative fluctuation. So clearly, as an objective method for determining refractive growth in infants and young children, cyclophagic techniques are superior to those that are non-cyclophagic. Okay, so not only the cyclophagic retinoscopy of infant and young children more accurate, it is more easily performed. Because the examination does not depend on the patient fixation distance. Okay, yes, batao.
Hello. हाँ सर.
Any two advantage of cyclophagic refraction?
सर एक तो अगर कोई patient कोऑपरेट नहीं कर पा रहा है तो उसके लिए साइक्लोपेजिक रिफ्रैक्शन करते हैं और दूसरा अगर कोई एरर आ रहा हो तो उसके लिए मतलब फोकस नहीं कर पा रहा है या फिर कोई एरर है सर
व्हिच टाइप ऑफ एरर किस टाइप का एरर
सर मतलब जैसे कि फोकस नहीं कर पा रहा हो वो कुछ भी हो सकता है
ओके तेजवीर एनीथिंग यू वांट टू ऐड
हेलो हाँ जी सर
ऐसा कौन सा रिफ्रैक्टिव एरर रहेगा जिसमें हम लोग साइक्लोपेजिक रिफ्रैक्शन करना ही है
ऐसा सर सर ऐसा तो
हाँ बताओ
सर लेटेंट हेपेटोमेट्रोपिया
ओके गुड व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड
ऐसा कौन है
What do you understand by latent hyperopia?
तो सर जो सर छिपा रहता है one diopter से ऐसे कुछ संतिग रहता सर ध्यान नहीं है बस आप पढ़े हुए थे
कहाँ पर तुम्हारे घर
okay later my okay सर isotropia में भी करते हैं
okay in one more
isotropia
good
और सर ये
ओके पोस्ट ऑपरेशन इज गोइंग टू बी एंड बी एल वेडनेसडे
टेक केयर
और क्लास गुड आफ्टरनून सो यस्टरडे वी हैव टॉक अबाउट द साइक्लोपेजिक रिफ्रैक्शन Many of you have made response very well. So, yesterday we have talked about the what do you mean by cyclophagia, what do you mean by cyclophagic refraction. Also, we have talked about the indication and advantages of cyclophagic. Okay, so. So today again we'll read about the advantage of cyclophagic drug in brief. So yesterday also I have covered. So few things I'll be added on that. Like in more general sense, cyclophagic refraction is also indicated in young patients. Okay, not only in children. So demonstrated any types of strabismus. Not only does cyclophagic allow the clinician to diagnose correctly any accompanying refractive error. So it is also prepared the patient for the dilated fundus examination. So all the strabismic patients should have through ocular health evaluation, especially when initially examined. Okay. So this evaluation can explore pathological etiology of the strabismus and also can conventionally be incorporated into the examination after the psychophysical reflection. So non-strabismic children with latent hyperopia are perhaps less obvious in their presenting, but this is another instance in which the information gained by the psychophysical reflection is essential to the ultimate management plan. So while considering the amount of total hyperopia in conjunction with the patient sign and symptoms, a successful spectral prescription should be determined more accurately. So we optometrists may consider using cycloplegic in children who exhibit myopia for the first time, and this approach allow the practitioner to rule out the accommodative spasm, which is also known as pseudo myopia. So as the etiology, so with the diagnosis of myopia established, future cycloplegic examination need not to be performed for the cooperative child. Similarly, presbyopia patient who have suffered a traumatic brain injury may manifest traumatic myopia or form of pseudomyopia. So everybody know about the pseudomyopia. So about pseudomyopia, I'm not going to discuss more. So cycloplegic reflection aid the clinician in both diagnosing and management of such patient. Okay, this type of patient we have to do the cycloplegic reflection, and it is most important in this kind of patient. So if we talk about the indication of cycloplegic drugs, then cycloplegic reflection is also indicated for the patient with active accommodative spasm. Those best corrected visual acuity is less than 20/20, and for whom there is no apparent reason for the decreased vision. So it allows the clinician to determine the whether the uncorrected refractive error, and is responsible for the reduced acuity. So this data may be practically helpful in young patient with the uncorrected anti-metropia and latent hyperopia, and also hyperopic anisometropia. Okay. So the amblyopic patient tends to have the inaccurate response during the subjective refraction, thus the necessitating the cycloplegic evaluation. So the cycloplegic retinoscopy reveals the true refractive error for which the clinician can base the patient with refractive correction. So the finally patient whose visual sign or symptoms do not correlate with the nature and the degree of the manifest refraction may be benefit from the cycloplegic evaluation. And cycloplegic refraction aids in the differential diagnosis by helping to ensure that the patient problem is not refractive in nature. So the optometry can then concentrate on other aspects of the visual system. Okay. So this table shows the indication of cycloplegic refraction, like infant, toddlers, school going children, non communicative patient, uncooperative patient, suspect of malingering or hysterical amblyopia, patient with the variables and inconsistent subject response during the manifest reflection. So strabismus patient, particularly exotropia, suspect of latent hyperopia, suspect of pseudomyopia, traumatic myopia, amblyopia, and visual acuity not corrected to the predicted level, patient with the symptoms seen unrelated to the nature or degree of the manifest refractive error. So this type of patient is mainly indicated for the cycloplegic refraction. Okay, so these are the points that we have to consider and put in your mind. So if you find any kinds of this patient, then you have to perform the cycloplegic refraction, especially in this patient, in this kinds of patient. And now if you talk about precaution and contraindication of cycloplegic refraction, then so before putting any cycloplegic agent, that may be atropine, that may be amitropine, that may be cyclopentaleate, so any cycloplegic agent, the clinician should perform a pre-instillation ocular evaluation So before installing any cyclopletic drug, that we have it first we have to examine all the so before installing any kinds of drug, any that may be midriatic, that may be cyclophagic, so it first we have to evaluate the all the ocular examination, which includes history part, that may be vision and refraction part, mainly dry retinoscopy you have to perform, and slit lamp examination should be performed, as I discussed in previous lecture. So every examination should be performed before installing any kinds of midriatic and cyclophagic drug. Okay, so if the patient is needed any midriatic and cyclophagic drug, then only we have to install and go for the further examination. So this evaluation not only protect the clinician regularly, but also provide the valuable information regarding contraindication to the drug. Okay, so this table shows the cyclophagic characteristics of common cyclophagic drugs, like as we know, like cyclophagic atropine and cyclopentalate, tropicamide, dormetropine, atropine, scopolamine, and they are used in residual accommodations and duration of cyclophagic effect and onset of maximum cyclophagic effect and commonly used concentration. Okay, like atropine, it has 1% and scopolamine have 0.25% and cyclophagic having 0.5 and 1% both. And if you talk about tropicamide, then it is having 0.5 and 1%. So go through this table to see the its effect and duration and relative residual accommodation. Okay. Now, if you talk about the agent using cyclophagic, then cyclophagic inhibit the actions of acetylcholine on the effector sites inhibited by the autonomic nerves. So this blocks the muscarinic receptor sites, and this also called the anti-muscarinic and cholinergic antagonist. Okay, cyclophagic drugs is also known as anti-muscarinic and cholinergic antagonist. Like we have discussed about the cholinergic receptor, so today in this lecture I'm not going to discuss it, but I have mentioned few of the points which is very important. Like cholinergic receptor in human eye have been found in iris, splenser, and the ciliary body, and it is one of the muscarinic type five subtypes of muscarinic receptor that I have taught in your class, like M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. Like here, M1 and M5 have been identified and in cyclophagic drugs, and the muscarinic agonist takes action at the receptor which constrict the pupil and contract the ciliary muscles in general lower the intraocular pressure. And it inhibitions of this receptor by the cholinergic antagonist induce the pupillary dilation, and also it helps to pulverize the accommodation of our eye. Now, before going to the clinical procedure, we have to know the selection and use of the cyclophagic. So where we can use the cyclophagic drug and how we can select. So all the cyclophagic eye drop exhibit the anticholinergic properties by the blocking the response of the acetylcholine and muscarinic receptors site, as I discussed in before slide. And clinically, this antagonist response is manifest on the some degree of hypolidization and cyclophagy. So there is some to be clinical useful cyclophagic drugs ideally possess the following properties, like rapid onset of cyclophagic and complete paralysis of accommodation, and there will be the adequate duration of maximum cyclophagy, and there will be rapid recovery of the accommodation and absence of side effects. So although no cyclophagic agent meet all these criteria, some agents satisfactorily achieve this desired clinical list of the clinical characteristics is common cyclophagic agent is currently used. So the pharmacologic properties of cyclophagic agent are discussed, and I will be discussing in another slide. So generally, when selecting the cyclophagic agent for the use in infant like 12 months of the age and younger, in patient with Down syndrome and in patient with the central nervous system disorder, and the lower in this case the lower concentration of the appropriate drug is recommended. So more especially when using propecamide and the cyclopentanate, concentration should be 0.5%, and it should be used rather than 1% concentration for this patient population. If the patient is coming with the central nervous system disorder and Down syndrome. Okay, now we come to the clinical procedure. So before coming to the clinical procedure, we have to know the administration of the cyclophagic agent. So many clinicians prefer to use the topical and anesthetic eye drop before inserting a cyclophagic drug. Why? Anyone want to get more?
और सर आईओपी वगैरह लेते हैं तो पेशेंट अच्छे से कोऑपरेट कर सके.
ओके, हम लोग जैसे कोई भी ड्रग वगैरह सब डाल रहे हैं तो क्या होती है साइक्लोपेजिक नहीं तो मीडियाटिक ड्रॉप वो सब थोड़ा सा क्या होता है ये थोड़ा सा वो लगती है वार्निंग सेंसेशन रहता है. तो इससे पहले हम लोग क्या करेंगे एनेस्थेटिक ड्रॉप वगैरह सब यूज करेंगे टू एनेस्थाइज आई. तो हम लोग वो क्या होता है एनेस्थाइज कर देता है सुन कर देती है आँख को. तो उसके बाद हम लोग कोई भी मीडियाटिक एंड साइक्लोपेजिक ड्रॉप यूज निकाल लेंगे तो उसको वो पेशेंट को फील नहीं होगा. इस वजह से हम लोग एनेस्थेटिक आई ड्रॉप वगैरह सब यूज करेंगे.
यस सर मैंने सही बताया था.
Because the anesthetic diminish the local stinging, irritation and the lacrimations that upon the accompany of the cyclophagic drugs. So several authors have reported increased corneal drugs penetrations and therefore increase the effectiveness of the phenylephrine after topical anesthesia. So the increased durations and effectiveness of cyclophagic may also occur after anesthetic eye drop. So the cyclophagic can be administered along or as a combination of cyclophagic or midriatic solution to permit the adequate binocular indirect ophthalmoscopy in a new state infant and young children. After cyclophagic refraction, the combination of drugs can be administered individually or as a combined solution. So most widely accepted cyclophagic refraction regimens include instillations of one drop of a topical anesthetic by one drop of 1% cyclopentanate and one drop of either 2.5% phenylephrine और 1% ट्रोपिकमाइड टू फैसिलिटेट द डायलेटेशन. सो आफ्टर वेटिंग 5 मिनट इंस्टॉलिंग ऑफ वन मोर ड्रॉप 1% साइक्लोपेंटालेट इज रिकमेंडेड इफ द पेशेंट इज अंडर 12 मंथ ऑफ एज. So the concentration of the cyclopentalate and tropicamide should be reduced to 2.5. And many studies shows that cyclophagic refraction may be performed after a little age, 10 to 12 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes in individually with the right iridis, and after 30 to 40 minutes individually with the dark iridized. So the cyclophagic and the combination of cyclophagic mydriatic solution can be administered to the eye as a drop, spray or ointment that may be atropine. So as a drop, the chosen solution should be installed in the traditional manner into the lower canalicular conjunctival sac with the eyelid open. So whereas the patient resistance to eye drop installation the drop, so it can be applied in the medical canthus to close eye after which the patient is asked to open the eye, allowing the patient to diffuse into the eye. So using the medical canthus drop installing method, one study evaluate mydriatic effect on tropicamide in adult, whereas the another study evaluate the mydriatic and cyclophagic effect of cyclopentalate is in children. Both studies found that mydriatic and cyclophagic were equal using the traditional open eye drop installation versus the medial canthus installation. So when the children were asked to evaluate the comfort between the two drop installing technique, here the 92% of the children survey reported better comfort with the medial canthus drop installing. Okay, तो हम लोग को यहाँ पर स्टडी वगैरह से दिखाया गया है कि हम लोग कोई भी ड्रॉप वगैरह से यूज कर रहे हैं तो उसको मेडियल कैंथस में हम लोग ड्रॉप वगैरह से वहां पर डालेंगे. Because the medial canthus technique, some clinicians found that spray are particularly effective in treatment in children who are resistant to drop installation in the usual manner. So several study compared the efficacy of the administering cyclophagic agent in a spray compared with the conventional eye drop. So cyclophagic agents were installed in 4 matched group of the child between 6 months to 12 years of age. So 68% of the eye were brown, 24% of the eye were blue, and 8% were calcified as other. Here the eye drops were installed in the eye that were open or closed, and cyclophagic spray was administered to open or close eye. So the residual accommodations were measured using the dynamic retinoscopy or a push-up method at various times after administering administration of the medication. So no statistical difference were reported in cyclophagic effect among the 4 groups. So another study also found that there is no statistical significant difference between cyclophagic eye drop installed in an open eye and spray administration to close eye based on the objective refraction measurement in children between 18 months and 6 years of age, with 62% of the subject having light eye and 38% have dark. This study also compare of administering of the two formulations and found the spray significant better. So the many practitioners must observe the recommended doses and cyclophagic refraction. So to over mediate when the maximum cyclophagic has been reached, increase the probability of the systemic drug absorption and risks of the side effect. So the optometrists using the spray method of installing also need to be diligent in preserving the extraneous drug spray from getting into the patient mouth or nose, because this increases the systemic drugs absorption and leads to increase the side and risks and side effects in the eye.
Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.